You bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. Oh, you bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. Oh, you bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. Oh, I'll do what you want me to do. Oh, you bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. You bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. Oh, you bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. Oh, I'll do what you want.
Shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily, shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. May the Lord have a blessing to the hearers, readers, and doers of his word. Amen. Amen.
Give us a God of love, a God of mercy. So Father, you just gotta keep calling on your Lord and Father. Please just have mercy on us, Lord. Help us. We know we got a long way to go. But Father, we don't believe that you brought us this far just to leave. So please just keep on having mercy on us. Lord, we pray that all of these and other blessings we bring your Son Jesus. Amen.
We will understand.
Bye. Bye.
Yes.
And we had the bomb.
Yes.
From OHS, we had Corbin Rito, we had Ashton Smith. From MACA, we had Ms. Kristen Sylvester. Okay, and then that's our high school grads. So 8th grade, we have Caitlin Sylvester. She's going to be crossing over from 8th to 9th at MACA. We have Nathan Hardy. He's at Port Barry High School, and he's going to be crossing over and going to high school there. And we also have Sister Darby Durio. She's crossing over at Lafayette Renaissance Charter High School, and her graduation is going to be tomorrow at 6 p.m. Anybody is welcome to come. I also have a special one from a loving mother. So she texted me this week. She said that that this young man, he finished and completed all assignments and his thesis, and he's going to be graduating from Columbia Southern University with a master's degree in occupational safety and health, and 2 graduate certificates in graduate safety and health specialist, and a graduate industrial hygiene specialist. This is from Kendall Sylvester Jr. All right. She got her BS in as a registered nurse from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. So we want to still recognize everybody on First Sunday. Send in your photos because we want to see y'all loving faces up on the screens right now. And we just want to make sure that y'all feel loved and welcome. And we do honor all graduates. And y'all parties have been phenomenal. And then next weekend we have Sister Kristen. Her party is going to be at 2. Okay, start at 2. Start at 2 at the Residence Center. Make sure y'all RSVP if she stays last week. Anybody as well. So that's what I need support. Thank you.
Good morning, sir. Marquita Robinson, Bobby Shelby, Pamela Andrews,
Joanne Tyler, Pastor William L. Moore, Jarvis Tyler, Donald Mallett, Watson Morrow families, Mary Jones, Eugene Jack James, the Livier family, Donald Bishop, Clara Pinkney, Lois Tessendorf family, Bertha Matthews, Elijah Mallett, Sheena Hart, Mildred Mallett, Tanya Parker, Shirley Durio Thomas, William Durio, Willie Durio Jr., Leanna Garrett, Tamika Smith, Alfred Mallett Jr., Kenneth Durio, the family of Jeanette Livier, Kayla Rand Albert, the family of Albert Davis, Cornelius Hardy Sr., Melissa Simon, Jackie Robinson, Stantasia Livier, Barbara Pickman, the family of Holly Pickman, Felicia Mallett and children, Philip and Tiffany Thomas, Casey and Kelsey Mallett, David Hardy, Virginia Pierre, the family of Deidre Pickman Keynes, just added today, also added Henry Taylor to your prayers, and Pastor Sylvester and his family. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Do we have any business? We ask you, we will do it. We understand. Amen.
Good morning. Thank God for being found within the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Once again, I'm just so happy to be here. To Pastor Sylvester and Sister Sylvester, I come in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Well, I am a member at Greater Shallow Baptist Church. Pastor Eric Dupre is my pastor. And thank God for being here today.
Amen.
God has led me to come and meet with you all today. And I'm so glad to be a part of your fellowship upon this morning. And I'm just going to sit back and I'm just glad to be here. And I'm just so happy to know that you're a part of my story.
Amen.
God bless you all and God keep you all.
Amen. On behalf of our pastor, officers, and members, we thank you for being with us. Continue to have a hallelujah time.
Amen.
Let's do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All God's children say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Truly God is good. He is good all the time.
Yes.
I just want to bring our attention, Brother Johnny, that key activist, wasn't that a scholarship as well to apply for?
Yes, sir.
What is the
Bible?
Okay. All right. If you'd like to, I don't know what was the grades, whatever, but I'll give your brother Johnny and maybe some scholarship money that your student may be available to them. So give your brother Johnny with that information. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Truly, God is good. He is good all of the time.
Yes.
Amen. Let us build ourselves according to the announcements that have been made. Amen. We thank God for this day. We thank God for us being in fellowship one with the other. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for our church family. Amen. Everybody standing over to me. Amen. My prayer is that we would show and share love one with the other. Because it would be a sin and a shame for us to regret not showing it to someone that God may remove from our lives. My prayer is that we would begin to show and share the love that God has shown us. Because when I think about what God has done for me, and the love that he showed me, and what he had to look over for me, I can't talk for nobody else. What he's done for me, how merciful he's been to me. And the Bible clearly says that we ought to forgive because we've been forgiven.
That's right.
And the Bible also says to owe no man but to love.
That's right.
Amen. So let's go and show and share love at this time. Amen. Let's go.
Thank you.
giver. Amen. So as you give, give out of a willing, cheerful heart. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. As I share with us all the time, check your heart before you write your check. Amen. 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 Again, if you need an envelope, give to the ushers. They'll make sure you give up. Amen. You can also give electronically in the time to act. Text to give. You can also go to our website as well. There's also our church app that you can go to as well if you desire to give electronically. But whatever you do, make sure you give cheerfully. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I want you to get your gifts together. And I want you to raise your gift to heaven. We're going to pray. If you give it already, just raise your hands to heaven. We're going to pray. Big God, we say thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to give. And Lord, we honor you because we know you gave us everything that you're giving.
Yes.
Lord, we know all of our blessings and provisions come from you.
Yes.
Blessed like only you can, Father God.
Yes.
Lord, we offer it up to you because we love you and you're worth every single penny that we're going to give. We love you, thank you, and praise you. It's in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray and ask God. Amen.
Amen.
I think you're coming around to receive that which you want to give up today. Thank you. number 28. Acts 20. Verse 28. Acts 20. 28. Word of God. It says, therefore, take heed to yourselves and to all the flock among which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to shepherd the church of God, which he purchased, the church say,
he purchased,
with his own blood. Amen. And grasp of the flower thereof fadeth away. The word of our God shall stand forever. Amen. You may be seated at this time. Amen.
Three things, right? When we look at the church, so watch.
We could not have church if you didn't show up. Okay? Couldn't have church. Right? We could come to the building, but we couldn't have church. Why? Because the church didn't show up. Right? There's three things we've got to understand about the church. Right? As it relates to possession. Right? Hear me well. Through the blood of Jesus, the church was purchased. First thing we got to understand, the church is for God, watch, by ownership. Amen. So watch. What do you mean, Pastor? You got to understand. He is, amen, the owner. And he holds the deed. Amen. And he has got everything in order. Right? But watch. Check it out. God also showed this up in the text. When we take a look at us being bought by the blood of Jesus as the pastor, watch this. The church is not mine, but watch. He says shepherd or feed, oversee. So it's the pastor by what? Responsibility by what? Stewardship. He's nothing more than a manager. And when we take a look at the church as a whole, the person sitting in your seat, the church is yours, watch, by membership.
Amen.
Right? But watch, at the end of the day, we all answer to the owner.
Amen.
Amen.
We all answer to the owner. Why? Because Jesus purchased the church with his own blood. Okay, preacher, why is that so important? It's very important. Because we've got to understand that even when we look at ourselves, we look at our lives, we look at our ministries, we look at our abilities, we look at our gifts, we look at the things that God has given us and allowed us to do, what we have to understand is that we are a purchased possession. Okay, preacher, why is that so important? Very important. If you understand your purchased possession, you realize you're no longer your own. When you understand you've been purchased by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, guess what? You realize, watch, you're not your own man and your own woman any longer. But watch, that doesn't apply to those, amen, praise the Lord, who just, you know, want something out of God just because they want something out of God. I'm talking to those who say, Lord, I give up my life because I understand and know what you've done for me.
Yeah.
Because there's a difference. There's a difference. Because when we look at what Christ sacrificed for us, do you realize God expects us to live our life as a watch? A living sacrifice. Sister Delilah sang a song earlier. Was Jesus bear the cross
alone?
The times in our life, as Christians, as the church, sometimes we have dreamy, unreasonable, worldly expectations as believers. Hold up, preacher. You're messing with your life. I really want you to study the Bible to say that you believe is God's word.
That's right.
And you will find that the Apostle Paul was about to go off to lose his life. Oh, Jesus. Watch for the same gospel that he preached. Oh, Lord, have mercy. But let me show you what he helped me to understand. He helped me to understand he was a purchased possession. And that's why the Apostle Paul was able to utter the words to live as Christ and to die again.
Yes.
Amen.
Purchase possession. And so many times as the church, we find ourselves expecting things or making, you know, different criticisms about different things, when in actuality, when we look at the word and what God has said, and even what other believers have gone through
Right.
It's totally different than what is being preached in many pulpits today. Okay, preacher, why are you saying that? Well, if you go to verse 29, it says, "For I know this, after my departure, savage wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock."
So true.
Oh, Jesus. That is the importance of us being able to be able to discern what is good from evil, what is of God and what is not of God.
That's right.
Because any Joe Blow can come along and tell you anything, and you'll run with it, believe it, and start saying stuff God never intended for you to say. There will be those that want to come along to actually not what? Bless the flock, but to actually devour the flock. Says also from among yourselves, oh Jesus, men will rise up speaking perverse things, why? To draw away disciples, why? After themselves. After themselves. Preacher, why is that so important and very important? I dare not let you make me your God. I dare not let you make me more important than God.
That's right.
And I dare not allow you to make me the one you call before you call on Jesus.
All right, come on now.
Because you got to understand that when we take a look at the church, we are part of the body of Christ that has been purchased by the precious blood of Jesus the Christ. And it's the Holy Spirit that will allow us to be able to discern, to see what's there, and to be able to see what's going on as it relates to what's going on around us, so that we're able, watch, to walk circumspectly to the word and watch, not be deceived. Not be deceived. I want to help us on the day that when we take a look at what Jesus did on Calvary's cross, we've got to understand this one thing. Many people, they make it about so many things, but you know what God showed me? That when we take a look at what Christ did on the cross, that was more valuable than anything else you might ever get in your life. Because can I help you? You want your soul to be at rest. You can live it up while you're here. Right? But at the same time, can I help you? This world is not our home. So what happened on Calvary's cross, can I help you, is more valuable than anything else that you can receive. Can I help you? Anything after that, the old folk will say is a lie.
All right.
And watch what God showed you. If he give you some extra stuff, fine. If he don't give you some extra stuff, tell him, still fine. Because Apostle Paul told me, whatever state I'm in, I learned to be content. We can't make it about the stuff. We've got to make it about the Savior.
Amen.
We've got to make it about the Savior. It is what Christ did. So here's what I want us to get, and I'm almost done. When we're sharing the gospel of Jesus the Christ, I want all of us to remember, yes, God can help us through. God can answer prayer. God can do amazing things. God can provide. But at the end of the day, you want the gospel to go forth, and the gospel says one understands that they're a sinner and they need a Savior. That is the gospel. You cannot effectively share the gospel without talking about sin.
That's right.
Why, Pastor? Because watch, If that's the case, then Jesus died for nothing. Right? We have been bought with a price. A high price. What a cheat. I heard an old preacher say, yeah, salvation might be free, but it wasn't cheap. Jesus gave his life, sacrificed his life on Calvary's cross. He endured the shame. He went through the things he went through. He became sin. He put sin on himself. Watch, not his own sin, our sin. So that we can be forgiven of our sin. He didn't do anything wrong. We did. He was buried in what the whole church would say a barber tomb only because he gave it back. He didn't stay there. And he rose the third day in victory over sin and death. Death couldn't hold him now. And he conquered what? He conquered sin. To show us that, guess what? We have the victory in Christ Jesus. So when we take a look at the Lord's Supper, when we take a look at what Christ has done, we take a look at what he did to purchase our soul salvation, we've got to understand this one thing, that when we look at our lives as believers, guess what? We owe it to God. We answer God. You know why? He's the owner. He is the owner. And watch, that's why we sing songs like I Surrender.
Yes.
Because watch, that surrendering says that, guess what? I give up trying to be the what? CEO and boss of my own life. And I realize that, guess what? That I'm under new management. Right? We have been bought with the price.
Oh, yes.
So when we take a look at that whole idea of ownership, stewardship, membership, let us always keep things in perspective. Because at the end of the day, God owns it all.
He sure does. That's right. That's right.
And when we look at the church, the church is not what you're looking at around here. The church is the one sitting in the
Yes.
We are the church. We can have church underneath that oak tree.
Amen. We are here.
Pastor, don't give you no ideas, Pastor. But it's the truth.
Yeah, we sure can.
Back in the day, they had church in the house.
That's right. Yeah.
And you know what? I found Sister Claire, we got Gucci. When we was in that old sweatbox church a long time ago, we worshiped God. If the temperature go up 2 degrees up in here, it's hot. We've got to worship. Certain relatives or men or women that and believers in Jesus the Christ, we are connected by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. That is what connects us. And that is what allows us to fellowship together, one with the other. And I'll leave you with this. When God made the purchase by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, he didn't ask your permission, but he bought it. Pastor, what does that mean? You can't pick your family. Because God showed me a long time ago, you and I have no heaven, no heaven, but nobody.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
That's right. All right. So when the purchase was made, can I help you? He bought it as it is.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Just like it was. But I thank God that through the Word, I thank God that through His Holy Spirit, I thank God that through His love, His grace, and His mercy, that through sanctification, He cleans me up as I go. Because I don't know about you, you and I can be a mess sometimes. But you better thank God for His grace. You better thank Him for His mercy. And can I help you? That's what's going to allow you to deal with other folks. Because guess what? When you thank Him what He's done for you, all that, you better get over some stuff when other folks done to you. Why? Because we know where He brought us from. We know what He delivered us from. Woo, Lord, have mercy. And when we take a look at what He's delivered us from, can I help you, Lord, have mercy? It'd be a whole lot easier for us to get over with other folks than
yes.
us.
Yeah.
He purchased our soul salvation through His blood.
Yeah.
The ultimate sacrifice.
Oh, yes.
He died. I could try to die for you to save you and to allow your soul to be saved. Guess what? I might save you in the moment, but I can't save you into eternity. Only the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
That is it.
Amen.
So when we take a look at that sacrifice, when we take a look at what Christ has done for us, let us never forget that we are His. We belong to God. We are no longer our own. And so when we look at that, we got to understand that guess what? We answer to God. Because why? He purchased our soul salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. We're good. Is our
prayer.
Who has never given their life to Christ.
Yes.
Never surrendered all to Christ. Never allowed themselves to be at a point to where they say, Lord, I'm a sinner.
Yes.
And I need your precious blood.
Yes, Lord.
Is there one on today? You've never given your life to Christ. You've talked of God. Called His name, but you've never given Him your life. There's a difference. It's a huge difference. You know, we'll do that with people, you know. We'll tell them, well, you pray. Well, you need to pray. But how you gonna pray to the Father? That's not you. Is there one?
pray right now, dear God, that as we partake, that we reflect, we understand the magnitude of your mercy. We love you, we thank you, and we praise you. It's in my name, Jesus, we do pray, ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Oh,
You bought me, Lord, paid the price. I belong to you. Oh.